Hey, what's going on, fam? Kyle Henderson along with Andrew Bone coming to you from beautiful Tuscaloosa, Alabama. This is a daily recruiting nugget. Starting the month of June, prospects can now visit Tuscaloosa, can visit with Nick Saban, the staff, get a real feel for Tuscaloosa here with Andrew Bone to talk about a big week of recruiting. And we lead off talking about Kojo Antwi, Rivals 100 wide receiver out of the state of Georgia. Bone recently spoke with him. What's kind of the latest there? And let's kind of dive into it as we kick off the month of June.
Yeah, as many Bama fans know, especially the ones on BamaInsider.com, you know, there were several big visitors on campus yesterday. I think there were five Rivals 100 prospects in town, including Kojo Antwi, the Rivals 100 wide receiver out of Georgia. You know, this was a big visit for him because it was his first trip to Tuscaloosa. He had a great time. Got a chance to speak to him, and you know, had a chance to work out with Coach Wiggins on Tuesday, and then had a chance to sit down with Coach Saban and get to know him a little bit better. This was his first visit to Alabama, and he's going to be coming back next week for his official visit. So he's coming in town June 8th and 9th for the official visit. I know he's got his first official visit this weekend at Georgia. He's going to visit some other schools, including Ohio State, Texas A&M, USC. So he's going to take those visits and then make a decision on July the 5th. But says Alabama really made a strong move with him after his first trip to Tuscaloosa. I'm really interested to see, you know, kind of, you know, will Alabama take it to the next level with him? I believe they will. And, I certainly think that, you know, he certainly has become a guy that that we're really kind of, you know, watching pretty closely, especially with him, you know, making two trips to Tuscaloosa this month. That's obviously going to be big for Alabama and for Kojo. So we'll see how it goes over the course of the next couple weeks and then leading up to his decision next month.
If you want to get the full scoop on his visit, go to BamaInsider.com. Check out any of the links to get inside those recruiting nuggets that you crave. Definitely now is a good time to hit the thumbs up, like, subscribe. We appreciate you more than you know. Bone, I also wanted to talk about Oscar Delp, one of the nation's top tight ends, to see if Alabama has made any ground up with a tight end. I mean, every single year, Alabama's, you know, always seems to go after these tight ends. Everybody's always asking about tight ends. And this year, Oscar Delp is kind of a name that early on in the month of June, people are curious about.
Absolutely. And, you know, Alabama's, I'm not saying they're in great shape at tight end because I do think they need another tight end in this class. They need an elite guy. They do have a commitment from Elijah Brown, who committed, back a few months ago, really one of the first commitments in Alabama's recruiting class. But Oscar Delp has really, shot up Alabama's recruiting board over the course of the last few months. He's continued to, develop the relationship there with the coaching staff and really had a great time. Georgia's has been the heavy favorite for him for a long time, but as many people know, they have a deep tight end group right now over in Athens. So can Alabama potentially take advantage of that? We'll have to see. I never really look too much at depth charts because a kid's going to go where a kid wants to go and where he feels like he can make the biggest impact. And I think Oscar Delp certainly is a guy that Alabama would love to add in this year's recruiting class. And he doesn't have an official visit set up with Alabama just yet, but says he is planning on taking an official visit. He's going to visit Clemson tomorrow for an unofficial visit. And he has some other official visit dates currently scheduled that he's going to take over the course of the next few weeks. But I certainly think that, as of right now, I'd still probably lean more towards Georgia just because they've been considered the favorite for him, really since day one. But let's see if he makes that trip back to Tuscaloosa for an official visit later on this month. And as of right now, probably going to decide sometime in July after these official visits happen. But I had a chance to talk to him after the trip. He came in town yesterday, worked out, hung out on campus, got a chance to see everything. It was his first time ever visiting Alabama. He came over with Kojo Antwi. They rode together. They rode with Oscar Delp's father. So they were all in town, stayed in town Tuesday and then left this morning. So it was a great visit. I mean, he really had a chance to, sit down with Coach Saban, learn a little bit more about him. Coach Saban, basically told him, hey, we can develop you into an NFL tight end. And we think you got a chance to really be, a great player here. And, you look at some of Alabama's past tight ends who are playing in the NFL right now, like O.J. Howard, Irv Smith Jr., and also, Jahlil Billingsley obviously had a tremendous year last year. So, you know, these are some guys that Alabama's really trying to sell Oscar Delp on becoming. So we'll see what happens there. But I do think Alabama made up a lot of ground with Delp, but we'll just have to wait and see if he comes back for the official visit.
Here with Andrew Bone talking Alabama Crimson Tide football recruiting. June is an action-packed month. Tons of guys in Tuscaloosa visiting with Nick Saban and the rest of the staff. You want the rest, go to BamaInsider.com. Promo to sign up is simply Roll Tide at checkout. Carson Hinsman is another prospect that we're going to talk about, Bone. Alabama always trying to load up on the offensive line. What's the latest on Hinsman and kind of the recruiting process as we enter the month of June?
Yeah, you know, we talked about Delp and Antwi, the two of the five guys who are in town, Rivals 100, a few other guys that were also on campus. Ty Simpson arrived yesterday. He's still in town today. Curtis Perry, defensive lineman from Montgomery, also camped at Alabama on Tuesday. Hadn't had a chance to catch up with Curtis Perry yet, but we did have a chance to talk to Carson Hinsman. Surprise visitor for Alabama yesterday, rated as the nation's top center, currently listed as 6'5", 280 pounds. Now, Hinsman told me that he measured at only 260 pounds at Alabama on Saturday. So a little light. I know Alabama probably wants him to get a little bit bigger. They did not extend him an offer yesterday, but he really enjoyed the trip, said that he would like to get back if they extend him an offer. So we'll see if that offer ends up happening. But, he had a great time in Tuscaloosa, said he really loved the Southern hospitality, said he loved the Southern architecture, everything that he saw on campus, and really kind of blew him away. So, had a great trip, but, still doesn't have that offer. Hoping to get one maybe down the road. Now, Alabama did tell him, they have some other guys that are coming in. They would like to take a center in this class. They have some guys coming in this month that they're trying to evaluate and then potentially going to make a decision here in the next few weeks or at the end of the month on a potential offer for Hinsman.
Here with Andrew Bone talking Alabama Crimson Tide football recruiting. Bone, Wednesday is a very big day. Couple prospects already been on campus. We're talking about a couple of them. You can read more at BamaInsider.com. Are we going to see any new offers extended this week? You got to think so with a lot of these names coming in.
I think with 25-plus recruits on campus today, we're going to see some new offers. Now, is that going to be in the 2022 class? Maybe, but I'm looking at 2023, 2024, probably going to see some more offers extended in those recruiting classes. There's just a lot of big names that are on campus, but a lot of in-state recruits in the 2022 class that are hoping to gain that offer or move up the recruiting board. And I'm talking about guys like Traquan Fagans, the four-star defensive back out of Oxford High School. Certainly a guy that Alabama has expressed a lot of interest in. They've talked to him a good bit, but I also think that they've been wanting to see him in camp. Antonio Kite, four-star safety out of Anniston High School. Now, I don't necessarily think Antonio has to camp. Alabama holds him in very high regard, but he's certainly a guy that they want to see in person. They want him to work out, want him to camp. Is he a safety? Is he a corner? But also, what's going to be priority number one for him once he gets to college? Is it going to be basketball or is it going to be football? Now, he just completed his first year of high school football this past season, really enjoyed it, and obviously garnered a lot of interest from different schools throughout the country, and including Alabama. Alabama's offered Antonio Kite in both football and basketball. So which sport's going to be his primary focus at the next level? I think those are some questions that Alabama has for him, and hopefully they're going to get some answers. I'm really interested to see kind of how Marquarius White, the three-star wide receiver from Clay Chalkwell, performs at the camp today, because he's certainly an electric athlete, one of the fastest players in the state of Alabama. He received an offer from Alabama back in the spring, but as I kind of say with many of these recruits, you still have to come to camp. You still have to perform. You still have to showcase yourself as being an elite player to be able to get that green light to commit to Alabama. So how well is he going to perform today? And there's some other guys that are in Tuscaloosa, hoping to get offers from Alabama today. Whether it's 2022, 2023, 2024, there's even some 2025 recruits that are camping at Alabama on Wednesday. So it's a big day in Tuscaloosa. I'm also really interested to see this big group from the state of Washington who's visiting Alabama, not only visiting, but camping. There's six players from the state of Washington that are visiting. Now, It's not JTT, JT Tuilomaloa. He's going to visit a little bit later this month, take his official visit on June the 25th. But some of his friends are in town. And I think Jaden Wayne, big-time defensive lineman in the 2023 recruiting class, is on campus today. He picked up an offer from Alabama about a month ago. Caleb Presley is a four-star defensive back, also in the 2023 class, same high school as JT Tuilomaloa. We could see him potentially get that offer today as well. So, big visit for a lot of top recruits that are on campus today.
Here with Andrew Bone talking Alabama Crimson Tide football recruiting. Bone, before we close out, a couple guys who are already committed to Alabama are going to be on campus either today or tomorrow. Let's talk about those prospects. Ty Simpson, the quarterback, and then the big man, Jaheim Otis, out of the state of Mississippi.
Yeah, these are guys that don't necessarily have to camp, but they want to. These are, guys who love competition, love competitive spirit, and that's what Nick Saban likes, probably the most about these guys is, even though they're committed, they're out here wanting to work out and go through the camp and, not only get coached by the coaches, but learn from them and, also be around other players. This is just a great opportunity for them to really learn from their future coaching staff. And Ty Simpson, I mentioned, and he arrived on campus on Tuesday, so he's been in town. I think he's got some other obligations this weekend, so that's why he's not visiting this weekend. But he's on campus today, on campus yesterday, and obviously around, two pretty big offensive targets in Kojo Antwi and Oscar Delp the last 2 days. And then you have Jaheim Otis, big defensive lineman. I think the one thing that I'm really anxious to see is, what is the accurate height and weight on Jaheim Otis? Because we've seen different things. We've seen 6'6", 350. I've seen 6'6", 300. And that's one of the biggest things about these camps. It's not necessarily you coming to campus and working out, but you got to get an accurate height and weight. And, we saw that, we talked about Carson Hensman a few minutes ago. He was listed at 6'5", 280 on the profile page, but measured in at 260 pounds. So how big is Jaheim Otis? Is he bigger than 350? Is he less than 350? So we'll hopefully get an accurate height and weight there here pretty soon. But obviously getting these two guys on campus to, not only work out, but also help recruit, obviously a big plus.
Hey Bone, what should we expect this week? I mean, there's tons of recruiting coverage right now on BamaInsider.com. Go to the website, read these exclusive interviews with our staff on these prospects that have visited T-Town. But for the rest of the week, I mean, tell our fans what to expect and, some other prospects that we should look forward to speaking about that will be visiting Tuscaloosa.
Well, we'll have more videos that we're going to do, especially after today. We'll do another video tomorrow, just kind of breaking down what happened, any offers that come through. We'll talk about any top performances. There's going to be some more players who visit Alabama on Thursday. Big official visit weekend. I think there's at least five official visitors coming into Tuscaloosa on Friday, and it's a big weekend overall. You have guys like a lot of unofficial visitors, including Jeremiah Alexander, the number one player in the state of Alabama, LT Overton, the top player in the country in the 2023 class. Those guys are going to be on campus this Saturday. We're going to have a ton of content throughout the rest of the week, interviews with players who attended camp or potentially picked up offers. And, like I said, we have tons of content on Bama Insider right now. We have, what to watch for on Wednesday. We have the interviews with Kojo Antwi, the interview with Oscar Delp, interview with Carson Hensman. We're going to have a lot of content on BamaInsider.com. So don't just wait for the videos here. Go get the scoop on BamaInsider.com right now, because that's where it is. We're continuing to post nuggets on the website. So don't wait for the video. Go check out the nuggets, because we're not putting everything out here on the video for free. We're wanting you guys come over to BamaInsider.com and read the content. And plus, guess what? You can ask me any questions at all, and I'll be happy to answer them for you.
So there you have it. You want the scoop? You want the nuggets that you crave? Go on over to BamaInsider.com. Hit the promo code ROLLTIDE at checkout to get free 30 days. And now is what better time than now, than June, all this recruiting scoop that you can become a member of BamaInsider.com. He's Andrew Bone. I'm Kyle Henderson. We'll be coming back with another daily recruiting video and more player profiles right here on BamaInsider.com. We sincerely appreciate you more than you know. Hit the thumbs up, like, subscribe, and we'll catch you next time right here on BamaInsider.com.